Hi everyone, welcome to Mash Math. Today we are going to study chapter 14 statistics, exercise 14.1, question 8. A class teacher has the following absentee record of 40 students of a class for the whole term. Find the mean number of days a student was absent. So number of days are given here, number of students are given here. So let's put this column as it is. So I have written down both the column here, number of days as it is given and number of students. So that's the frequency. So now all these sums till seventh sum, I did it in step deviation method. You can do whichever method you want, but in this particular sum, we cannot do step deviation method. I'll explain you why. So one of the important thing to before going deciding which step, which method you want to do, I told you step deviation method is the most easiest method. But then before proceeding to step deviation method, always you have to check the class interval. So here you see the class interval. Class interval meaning the difference. Okay, difference, common difference should be same, then only you can do step deviation method. If not, better to go for direct method or assumed mean method. So here you see between 0 to 6, what is a class interval? 6. No, how to find out class interval? Upper limit minus lower limit. Okay, class interval, how to find out? Upper limit minus lower limit. So if you see here, upper limit is 6, lower limit is 0. 6 minus 0 will be 6. But then here you see 10 minus 6, 4. 14 minus 10, 4. 20 minus 14, 6. So if you see here itself, we don't have a common difference same. Here it is 6, here it is 4, here 4, here it is 6. So when class interval is not same, then we cannot do step deviation method. Because step deviation method formula is what? Step deviation method formula is A plus H Fi ui divided by summation of Fi. So this is step deviation method formula. So A we will get. H is what? H is class interval. And what class interval can we give here? Because here you have class interval 6. Here you have class interval 4. Here you have class interval 4. Here you have 6. So which class interval can you give here? So H value is not steady. Therefore, step deviation method we cannot do. So whenever you get the sum, to when they ask you to find out the mean, then first thing you have to check whether the class interval is same or not. First of all, you have to see whether it is continuation or no. So here it is continuation. 0 to 6, 6 to 10, 10 to 14, 14 to 20. Continuation is there, but then class interval is different. So when class interval is different, just don't do step deviation method, because you can't do it, because we don't have a proper H value. So therefore, in this sum, we will do the direct method. So for direct method or any method, first we have to find out xi. And xi is what actually? Xi is upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. So that's what we have to do. And I told you, if class interval is same, if it is common difference same, xi, I told you what to do. You have to just go on add. But here class interval is different everywhere. So then you have to calculate this. Okay. So now let us calculate. The first thing is 0 plus 6 divided by 2. Let us do here. Or upper limit plus lower limit, right? 6 plus 0 divided by 2. 6 upon 2. So 3 we get. Then next, 6 plus 10. 6 plus 10 is 16. 16 divided by 2. Get 8. So next, 10 plus 14. will give us 24. So 24 divided by 2, we will get 12. Then 14 plus 20, then divided by 2. So 34 divided by 2, you will get 17. Then next 20 plus 28, 48 divided by 2 will give us 24. Then 28 plus 38 divided by 2, that is 66 divided by 2 will give us 33. Then 38 plus 40, that is 78 divided by 2 will give us 39. So that's how we have to do this exercise. If the class interval is same, if everywhere it is 6, then what we will do, just you add with this 6, next value will get, then you add 6, next value, add 6, you will get next value when class interval is same. But here class interval is different, and therefore for each one you have to calculate and find out xi. So now for direct method, what we have to do, fi and xi. So fi xi, just you multiply this, 11 into 3, 33, 10 into 8, 80, 7 into 12, 84, 4 into 17, 68, 4 into 24, 96, 3 into 33, 99, 1 into 39, will give us 39. Okay, so this is for direct method. If you want to do assumed mean method, then you have to find out a di here. So how to find the di also, I told you, xi minus a will be di, but direct method also is okay. So let's do it. So now what we have to do, we have to sum up all this. So summation of fi and xi. So when you total it, you will get 499, and here summation of fi is 40. So now put it in the formula, that is x bar equal to summation of fi xi divided by summation of fi. So then you have 499 divided by 40. So then divide 499 divided by 40. 49, one time you have 40. Then you will get 9. 99, 9 will come down. So in 99, 2 times you will have 40, 80. So you will get it 9, 1. So now put decimal, add 0 here. So how many, now 0 is here, 0 is here, so let's not consider. 4, how many times will be there in 19? 4, 4s are 16. So 4, 4s are 16. So then 0, let us put it because we have 0. Then 0, 3. Again in 30, 40 will not be there, so we add 0. So now how many times? 7, 4s are 7 volts are 28, so 0. So then 0, 10 minus 8, 2, 20. So again add 1, 0. So again to 5, 40s are 200. Okay, so we got 12.475. But in your textbook, you will have answer 12.48, because see here 7 is there, after 7 5 is there, so always we consider next. If it is 5, we make it half, we make it full. In your tech, when you get exam marks, if you have 4.5 marks, we make it 5, right? Because when it is half, then we make it full. So here it is half, 5 is a half, so we make it this as a full. So that's how it becomes 48. So what is the question? Find the mean number of days a student was absent. So days it is. So 12.48 days. So this is our answer. That's it. Thank you. God bless you.